The Venus flytrap is this carnivorous plant that has like two leaves, and when a fly is coming and touching these hairs, it closes very quickly. This is one of the fastest movements in the plant kingdom. It has what is called bistability. So there is one state and then you just need to touch it and it will change to the other state. So that's what we've seen with this type of composites. Our way to do it is not having something that is standard, but designing it so that we can orient particles, not only straight, but in more complex orientations. We use magnetic fields to align these micron particles, and by doing so, they can make composite that change shape as well. Having such a curved piece, this is inspired from the Venus flytrap leaves. What we are trying to do is understand the correlation between the shape, the deformation, and how to close the trap. Based on finite element modeling, we can tune the reinforcement lines, tune the geometry, so that we can in the end have a composite where, putting the two leaves, we can close it totally. Airplanes, cars, they are all made of composites. Robots, where you want, for example, a system to grab something that you cannot reach or that would be in an unusual environment. So there you need to trigger it from far away. There would be many applications for this. By using a composite, it would be cheaper first to make it, because polymers are cheaper. They will be lighter, so you will also save energy. So it can be as strong as a metal, but lighter than a metal. So if you think of an airplane, then you would need less fuel and so on. This is also very interesting to see how nature does this naturally, and we can imitate nature, but we can even do better, because we have many tools in the synthetic walls. We can use different polymers, we can use different particles, so we can even make it better.